Customs controls increase the effort and cause delays in transport. The EU resale right remains in force for the time being. Those buyers in the EU who bought and already received a work of art in London shortly before Christmas are currently among the lucky ones. Due to concerns about the mutated coronavirus, France had temporarily closed the borders with Great Britain and temporarily plunged the transport system on the English Channel into chaos. In some cases, there was a massive delay in shipping, which is still having an effect and which was made worse by the Brexit that took place at the turn of the year. The customs border, which has been in force since January 1st, is associated with declarations for exports and import, as well as the corresponding administrative and financial effort involved in preparing the accompanying documents. Not to forget the idle times of means of transport. In view of the poor staffing of the customs administration in the United Kingdom and the still developing electronic customs declaration system, warns the Austrian Trade Board that serious delays are to be expected in the initial phase, and that is still ongoing. It is irrelevant that there are no customs duties for art, but import sales tax in the EU 27. Also for works of arts that were acquired before the beginning of the year and are still in transit. Also for those of consigners who have remained unsold. The sales tax for art in Austria and thus also for imports from third countries is normally 13% for art, but was reduced to 5% by the end of the year due to the pandemic-induced economic downturn. For antiques, however, 20% import sales tax is due. Art shippers like Gander and White from London also know about teething problems. Specifically in the case of air freight, customs officers with no experience in handling works of art also occasionally open transport boxes at destinations, as the art newspaper currently reports. And that's a problem because the objects could be damaged if improperly handled. As relieved as the British agreement may be or may make people when it comes to the trade in art, the London marketplace is threatened with competitive disadvantages. Potential sellers of works that tend to enjoy strong demand in the EU could in future also give preference to auction houses there. Connoisseurs believe that Paris has the best chance of replacing London as the center of European art market in the foreseeable future. To counteract this, the agreement provides for the option of a temporary import, which means that any taxes are only incurred upon sale. The British Collecting Society, that's the Design and Artist Copyright Society, has announced that the resale rights regulation adopted at EU level in 2001 has been maintained. Accordingly, during the artist's lifetime and up to 70 years after their death, a fee of at least 4% of the net sales price, that starts at €2,500, is still due for each sale of an artwork, but a maximum of €12,500 per work of art and change of ownership. In 2017, the British Art Market Federation advocated a Brexit adaptation, according to which this should only apply to works by living artists. A demand that contradicts existing copyright regulations and would have given the rest of Europe a massive competitive disadvantage in the modern segment. That's why that didn't happen. The EU is not that stupid, just to say that in the end. But if you want to stay informed, please subscribe to my channel and my other channels. I'll see you in my next video. Auf Wiedersehen.